Do portal axles reduce torque twist? Yes, no, sort of. On this channel, we look at the science behind our grown-up toys. Adding a portal axle may reduce perceived torque twist, but it's not because of the axle. Here's why. What is torque twist? As you can see here, it's when the perpendicular torque of the motor twists the front axle relative to the rear axle, and one of the front wheels has a tendency to lift up. It could be the left or the right, depending on your motor orientation. Let's start as simply as possible and build from there. Picture your motor is directly connected to your wheel. Newton's third law: for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. So let's say your wheel is spinning counterclockwise. The axle is also spinning counterclockwise, as is your motor spindle. The motor housing wants to spin in the opposite direction to resist that force. We'll call that clockwise. When your wheel encounters resistance, then that resistance is transmitted to your motor housing, which wants to rotate in the opposite direction to oppose that. Here it is from the side view. Your wheel wants to rotate counterclockwise, and your motor housing wants to rotate clockwise. Now, since your motor is attached to your skid or your chassis, your skid wants to turn in the opposite direction of your wheels. And it looks like this. Your motor housing and your skid, which are attached, are rotating in the opposite direction that your tires are wanting to rotate. Now, the magnitude of this blue force. Let's assume this blue force is the amount of torque needed to move your vehicle forward. That includes the weight of the vehicle, any wind resistance, the steepness of an incline, and the rolling resistance. So this blue force is the force required to overcome all of that, move your vehicle forward. And that same force is going to be reacted at the skid, the chassis, the motor housing. Everybody good so far? Now let's picture a simple gear reduction added to the model. Let's just say 5-to-1 to keep it simple. This 100 inch-pounds, let's just assume, is what it takes to move your vehicle forward. If you have a 5-to-1 gear ratio, then you only need 1/5 of that 100, which is 20 inch-pounds at the motor. So let's add some more gears in. Let's say on a straight axle design, we've got a 50-to-1 gear reduction. And that's not a completely unreasonable number. But let's again assume that it takes 100 inch-pounds of torque at your tire to move the vehicle forward. With a 50-to-1 reduction, you only need 2 inch-pounds at the motor to put out that drive torque. Now let's assume we have a portal axle. Let's just assume a 2-to-1 reduction in the portal axle itself, just to keep things simple. Stock Capra is actually 1.9-to-1, and if you have overdrive gears, you might get down to 1.3-to-1, but just to keep the illustration simple, let's say it's a 2-to-1 reduction. So on a straight axle, we had 50-to-1. Now we're at 100-to-1. What does that mean? Well, it should be obvious that, again, maintaining 100 inch-pounds at the axle, you only need half as much force, which is now down to 1 inch-pound. Remember, it was 2 inch-pounds on the straight axle. So with half the motor force, you're going to have half the reduction force, which means half of the torque twist. But let's look at something else. You may have geared your motor down all the way down to 1 inch-pound, but your motor is capable of putting out 2 inch-pounds. So let's say you're putting out 2 inch-pounds because we know that's what the motor was capable of in the straight axle example. You could potentially achieve 200 inch-pounds at the wheel. Then you have the potential of twice the output if you need it. your total maximum torque twist would be the same in this scenario. You just have double the wheel torque. So now let's go back and look at the motor in the chassis. If we start here, you've got your motor and a gear reduction going to the wheel. This is what a typical MOA or motor on axle looks like. When the wheel wants to rotate counterclockwise, your motor rotates clockwise, and you don't have any twist because the motor is rotating about a parallel axis to your axles. If you're driving an MOA, you can stop watching now. For the rest of us with driveshafts, keep watching. Here is what a driveshaft vehicle looks like. You've got a set of bevel gears in the axle, and that changes the reaction force at your motor. It turns the reaction force 90 degrees to your axle. To make it a little more realistic, you've got a drive shaft between your axle and your motor, and imagine a transmission in here as well. But to keep it simple, let's just use this diagram. Here you have your wheel, again, rotating counterclockwise, but your motor housing is now rotating perpendicular to the axle axis. And what that does is it wants to rotate your motor sideways, and your skid and your chassis want to go with it. This is what torque twist starts to look like, because your motor is now wanting to resist your wheel force at a different direction than your wheel axis is turning. So there's two things going on here. First of all, your chassis, skid, motor housing rotates relative to the rear axle. That's half of your torque twist. Then your front axle rotates relative to your skid and motor. That's the second half of the torque twist. So you've got double the twist propensity wanting to occur. If you only have rear wheel drive, you only get half of this effect. If you've got four wheel drive, you're getting double this torque twist. Making sense? There is a misconception that moving the gear reduction to the axle away from the transmission somehow changes the torque twist. Let me explain why that is not the case. All of your axles, all of your gear reduction are rolling on bearings. Your bevel gear is on bearings, your transmission axles all roll on bearings, your portal gears run on bearings. Bearings isolate any forces being transmitted to the housing that they might sit in, except for a small amount of rolling resistance and seal friction. Gear shafts and drive shafts cannot impart a force to the housing they sit in, whether it's the axle or the chassis or something else. The only reactions to consider are the motor mounts and the tire contact patch. Nothing in between matters, because nothing in between can impart a force on the housing it's sitting in. The only thing that matters to torque twist is the total gear reduction from the contact patch to the motor housing. It doesn't matter where the gear reduction occurs. The only thing that matters is the total reduction. As you can see, moving gears from the transmission to the axle doesn't change the total gear reduction, and therefore doesn't change the amount of torque twist. So now you know, torque twist is a function of your total gear ratio from wheel to pinion. In general, not always, portals just happen to reduce the gear ratio by default. Assuming the portal axle adds a 2-to-1 gear ratio to your drivetrain, you could achieve the exact same result with straight axles if you can cut your gear ratio in half. Get a transmission with lower gears, or drop your pinion size in half. Those are options. Now you know about portals and torque twist.